Hello. Today we are going to make a dollhouse using cube sculpture. We already made cubes in previously published instructions cube and instruction fabric 3 cube. Today we are going to work in slightly different ways. Inflate two balloons leaving about 8 inch flat tails. We are going to twist all bubbles of the same about up to 1 inch size. In this example I'm going to use two or three balloons to make each side of the cube. Each side of the cube is a square with sides 6 by 6 bubbles. Here we twist a chain of 5 bubbles and lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 bubbles. We have made the center part of the square. Now we twist a chain of the next 3 bubbles. I use brown balloons to make this side of the cube to represent the floor of the house. Now we lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 bubbles in one lock twist. You have to force the rest of the balloon through the loop of 4 bubbles at the center of the square. This way we work around the center square to make the second and then third row of the square. Twist a chain of the next 3 bubbles, lock both ends of the chain of the last 8 bubbles in one lock twist. The cube sculpture has 6 sides. I'm going to try to make each side in slightly different ways, and I will connect sides of the cube in different ways as well. For this reason it's not going to be the perfectly designed dollhouse. I just want to show you a couple ideas that you can use to make your own dollhouse. I hope you will watch the instruction first, make your choice how you want to make the dollhouse, what type of connections to use, and then make the dollhouse. And now back to our sculpture. Here we have to twist a chain of the next 2 bubbles. And now we lock both ends of the chain of the first and the last 16 bubbles in one lock twist. So far we have made a square shape with sides 4 by 4 bubbles. Remember, in this example we're making a cube with sides 6 by 6 by 6. So now we have to work the third row around the square to make the square with sides 6 by 6. I'm going to fast play most parts of this video. It could take about a couple hours to make this sculpture, because we have to twist and connect more than 200 bubbles. I always try to use balloon to twist as many bubbles as I can, but eventually we have to cut off the rest of the balloon and tie off the end, attach the second balloon and work your way around the square to make the third row. Working in this fashion we can add more balloons to make much larger size square pieces of fabric. Okay, we have made the square with size 6 by 6 bubbles, cut off the rest of the balloon, tie off the end. Alright, now we're going to make the second square piece of fabric with size 6 by 6 bubbles. This time I want to use a clear color balloon to make the center part of the square, 4 by 4 bubbles, to represent the window. Twist a chain of the first 7 bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 bubbles. Twist a chain of the next 3 bubbles, and then we lock both ends of the chain of the last 8 bubbles in one lock twist. Keep working in the same fashion. This time we work easier and faster than we did the first square. As you remember, we started the first square with 5 bubbles. Now we don't have to pull the rest of the balloons through the loop of 4 bubbles. That's a time saving. We have to lock both ends of the chain of the last 16 bubbles in one lock twist. Cut off the rest of the balloon and tie off the ends. And now we have to just tie the ends between bubbles, or should I say, lock both ends of the chain of the last 12 or the first 4 bubbles in one lock twist. Okay, we have made the square shaped piece of fabric with sides 4 by 4 bubbles. Once again, it's going to be the center part of a square piece with sides 6 by 6 bubbles. I use a clear balloon to make it so it would represent the window. Let's attach the second balloon, I use blue color, to make the third row of our square. And now we work in the same fashion as we did previously with the brown square 6x6 bubbles. There is going to be just one difference, very important. Remember, we're making cube. It means that we have to make six square sides and connect them to each other to make the cube shape. So now we're going to make and connect one side of this square to one side of the first, the brown square. At this point we can connect any sides of the squares. There are six bubbles on each side, so we have to make three connections between two squares. It's quite simple, but time-consuming process. As we make blue bubbles of the second square, we have to force the rest of the blue balloon between appropriate two brown bubbles of the first square. Working in this fashion, we will make two square pieces connected between each other, which will make one rectangular shape with sides 6x12 bubbles. This rectangular shape would make two sides of our cube. Alright, here we have connected these two pieces, and now we just have to finish the second square piece. And then we cut off the rest of the blue balloon and tie off the ends. In this sculpture I use double knot to secure all ends. And you can use scissors to cut off balloons and trim off the ends. So far we have made a brown floor and a blue wall with a window. Let's make the third square piece to represent another wall. And I want to start building corner of the cube. Let's twist a chain of first two bubbles. I found it easier for me to pull chain of small bubbles through the loop than do it with the long end of the balloon. Lock the free end of the second bubble between two brown bubbles at the corner next to the wall. Tie the nozzle of the balloon between the next two brown bubbles. Twist the third bubble. Lock the free end of the third bubble between the two blue bubbles at the corner of the wall. We just have made the first corner of the cube. This time, as you can see, we work the square piece starting from the edge of the square, not from the center as we did the first two square pieces. So here we're twisting the bubbles and connecting them to the side of the blue wall as we're making them. As we get to the top of the blue wall, there will be nothing at this moment to connect the third square piece to. So far we have twisted seven bubbles and they all attach to the first two square pieces. Now we have to do little math. We're making square with sides 6x6. Total of 36 bubbles. The edge of the square, or the third row of the square, is made total of 20 bubbles. We already connected chain of the 7 bubbles, so let's make a chain of 11 bubbles to get to the corner of the floor, and then we will twist two more bubbles to finish the third row. So here we have made 7 plus 11, total of 18 bubbles. Lock the free end of the 18th bubble between two brown bubbles at the corner of the floor. That's the way it will look like when we're done. Twist a chain of the next two bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 20 bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the edge of the third square piece. Cut off the rest of the balloon, tie off the ends. Now we're going to use the second balloon of the same color to make the second row of the third square. Twist a chain of first two bubbles. We can start the second row at any point. Let's lock the free end of the second bubble between two bubbles closer to the top of the wall. Tie the nozzle of the balloon between nearest two bubbles closer to the bottom corner. Twist the third bubble. Here we're making the top corner. Lock the free end of the third bubble between the second and third bubble from the corner. Twist the chain of the next two bubbles. Lock free end of the fifth bubble between the nearest two bubbles. Twist the sixth bubble, making the corner of the square. In the same fashion, we work the rest of the second row of the square. It takes total of 12 bubbles to make the second row. Two bubbles for each side, one bubble for each corner. Once again, we are making the third side of our cube. It represents a wall with a window. The brown piece represents the floor. The second side we made represents a wall with a window 4x4 bubbles. And now we're finishing the wall with window size 2x2 bubbles. Once again, let's use clear balloon to make the window. Simply twist a chain of 4 bubbles. Make these 4 bubbles slightly bigger size than we used to make the wall. This way it will fit better inside of the wall. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 4 bubbles in one lock twist. Cut off the rest of the balloon, tie off the ends. And just tie the window to the wall. We have to make just one connection, window with the wall. The connection works as a hinge for the window, so we can open and close it. We have made the third side of the cube. Here I use dark blue balloon to make the fourth side of the cube. It represents the wall with a window again. Let's twist a chain of 3 bubbles. Lock the free end of the third dark blue bubble between 2 brown bubbles at the corner of the cube. Lock the free end of the first dark blue bubble between nearest 2 brown bubbles. Twist the fourth bubble. This time I want to use different type of connection between walls. It involves extra bubble. Here we are. Twist the fifth bubble. Lock both ends of the fifth dark blue bubble in one lock twist. Later we will use it to make the connection between walls. Twist the chain of the next 3 bubbles. Lock both ends of the eighth bubble in one lock twist. Twist the chain of the next 3 bubbles. Lock both ends of the 11th bubble in one lock twist. So here we have 3 extra bubbles, the 11th, the 8th and the 5th. Now it is very simple to connect walls using the extra bubbles. Just force extra bubble between 2 bubbles of the other wall. We worked before with extra bubbles as a connection between walls in previously published instruction Fabric 3 Cube. So check it out again if you need. In this example, we work the square starting from the edge, the third row. In this example, I use extra bubbles to connect walls. We use a regular connection between wall and the floor. And I don't make extra bubbles between wall and roof. Here I'm doing some mess to make the extra bubbles for the next wall. Twist the 18th bubble, lock both ends of the 18th bubble in one lock twist. At this point I have to add the second dark blue balloon and use it to finish the rest of the wall. Work in the same fashion. Here we made the third extra bubble, twist the next bubble, lock it between 2 brown bubbles at the corner. Twist the 26th bubble, lock both ends of the chain of the first or last 26 bubbles in one lock twist. Yes, in this example, we use 26 bubbles to make the edge of the square piece. Use the rest of the balloon to make the second row of this square. We work it in the same pattern as previously. Two bubbles for each side and one bubble for each corner. It takes total of 12 bubbles to make the second row. Cut off the rest of the balloons. Use scissors if necessary. Remember to tie off the ends. Okay, so far we have made 4 sides of the cube. For me personally, it seems easier and faster to make connection between walls using extra bubbles. I'm gonna skip the window, leave it open. Why not? And now I'm going to use yellow balloon to make the 5th side of the cube. It will represent the wall with a door. Let's use the first yellow bubble to make the corner between brown and light blue sides. So as you can see, we work this side of the cube starting from the edge of the square. This time I connect walls in regular way without any extra bubbles. And here we lock free end of the 11th yellow bubble with dark blue extra bubble at the top of the wall. Work the yellow balloon down to the brown side. Use the 16th bubble to make the corner between dark blue and brown sides. To make the door, I have to work the yellow balloon in opposite direction. Twist the chain of two, the 17th and 18th yellow bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last four yellow bubbles in one lock twist. At this point, I'm going to attach the second yellow balloon. We have already made the edge of the yellow side of this cube. It made total of 16 yellow bubbles. And it takes total of 12 bubbles to make the second row of this yellow side. Cut off the rest of the balloon, tie off the ends. We have made the wall with a pinion for the door. The door is a rectangular shape with sides 8 by 2 bubbles. I'm going to use a red balloon to make the sixth side of this cube. I work this square piece starting from the center. Work in the same fashion as we did the window with sides 4 by 4 bubbles. Attach the second red balloon and use it to make the edge, the third row of the square. I'm going to make three extra bubbles, connection bubbles, on each side of the square. If necessary, use a third balloon to finish the square. This side of the cube represents the ceiling or roof of the house. In my opinion, it makes a lot of sense to use extra bubbles for connection between walls, especially when you want to keep the corners under right angle. Okay, here we have made the square, the sixth side of the cube. Now let's assemble the cube. We have to force red connection bubbles between appropriate bubbles of the walls. Congratulations, we have made the cube. And we can use the cube as a dollhouse. Here's a roof, here's a floor, four walls, windows, and door. With regards for the door, we made just a pin for the door. Let's make the door. I use orange balloon. The door is represented by a rectangular shape, 8 by 2 bubbles. The rectangular shape is made by two squares with sides 2 by 2. I connect the long side of the door to the wall. So there are two connection points. So we can open the door or close it. It works the same way as the window we made with sides 2 by 2 here. Alright, the flat roof looks okay, though we can and we like to make it different. About 2 weeks ago we made a cube. It's still alive, though it shrinks a lot. Nevertheless, as I mentioned before in the instruction cube, we can fold the cube and use it as a roof. Alright, let's make a variation of the roof. Let's use 6 balloons, 3 pairs. We're going to make two connected squares with sides 6 by 6 bubbles. In this example, I want to use extra the connection bubbles to make the corner of the roof, the top of the roof. And also I want to make extra bubbles on one side of the roof, right here. That's where I want to connect the triangular shape piece of fabric. In this example, it's going to be the front side of the roof, front side of the house. I want to keep open the back side of the roof. This way we can put some toys inside under the roof, you know, in the cellar to play some kind of games. Here we come to the top of the roof. Remember to make extra bubbles to reinforce the corner. We work the second square of the roof in the same fashion. In this example, I'm going to attach roof to the walls using the ends of the balloons. Otherwise, we can make connection bubbles, the extra bubbles, at the edge of the walls or at the edge of the roof and use the connection bubbles to connect roof to the walls. So here we cut the rest of the balloons, leaving long ends. Tie off the ends, don't trim them yet. I'm going to use two balloons to make the triangular shape. Twisted chain of first 4 bubbles, lock both ends in one lock twist. Twisted chain of the next 11 bubbles, lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 bubbles in one lock twist. Now we work in opposite direction, 2 bubbles for the side, 1 bubble for the corner. Cut off the rest of the balloon and tie off the ends. I want to use clear color balloon to make a window, triangular shaped window on the roof. In this example, I start from the base of the triangle, tie the nozzle of the clear balloon, twist the clear bubbles and work them along the green bubbles. Here we make a chain of first 5 clear bubbles, lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 clear bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the 6th clear bubble, lock both ends of the chain of the last 2 clear bubbles, the 5th and the 6th bubble, in one lock twist. We have to roll the 5th bubble around the 6th bubble. So it takes 7 bubbles to make this triangle. Cut off the rest of the balloon and tie off the ends. We have made the triangular shaped piece of fabric. Going to attach it on the front side of the roof. Use connection bubbles at the edge of the roof. In this example, the base of the triangle protrudes slightly from the roof. That is a geometry issue. If we make a triangle one row shorter, then we'll get a hole between roof and the wall. Alright, we have made the roof, and now let's attach the roof to the walls. I place the front side of the roof above the wall with the door. We can connect the roof to walls using ends of the balloons. Also, in this example, we made the red side of the cube with connection bubbles, so we can attach the roof using red connection bubbles. Let's fix all bubbles in proper positions. Congratulations, we have made the dollhouse. It is very basic, simple dollhouse with 4 walls, 1 roof, 1 door, 3 windows. I think it should look better if we use just 1 color balloons to make all walls. And using connection bubbles to connect the same color of walls looks better too, in my opinion. At this moment, I don't have enough helium-filled balloons to suspend this dollhouse in air. That's another good idea for party. The size of our dollhouse is big enough to play with Super Kira action toys. Just make sure to balance the dollhouse on a flat surface. We can do it with any small format book. Just put the book flat on the floor inside of the dollhouse.
A book in a house?
Yeah, book in the house.
He can't get in.
He can get it in. He can. Так. Счастье. Заспана. Yeah. And there is a window that you can open. Well, one window you can open, the small one. Another one is sealed. And the third one is broken. On my side, with a blue wall, dark blue wall. Not on your side. On your side is okay. It's a big window, like in your apartment. Yeah. Peter Parker is coming home. Uh-oh. This window is open.
That one is open.
Yeah, and the other one is broken. Yeah.
So fix this one.
You can.
Some places down here.
Uh-huh. Have fun and happy twisting.